Yeah, hopefully. Well, this is a great, great thing. Yeah. Do you mind if I lay on you? I'm still a little bit tired.
Sure, I don't mind.
Then I'll know what to do.
No. I need help. I need help. Well, whenever you want to talk, we can always come here. You need to go home, talk to your wife. Tell her yourself. Tell her that you're gonna get help. She has a drinking problem. You're right. I need to do it. I need to get help for me, my wife, and my children. They need me. Thanks.
I'm doing the right thing.
Yeah, I know. This is my last drink. Is there a possible way you could take the mask off?
Yes, but only for a little while.
You hear me, honey?
I can hear everything you're saying. I will try my best to make it. Put the mask back. You should keep calling your children now.
I'm a friend of his. I'll let him know as soon as possible. You're welcome. Bye. Michael, I hope you're done in the shower.
You know what I do when I'm really, really tired and I want to wake up? One, I drink coffee. Two, I listen to loud music and dance.
Really?
Yup.
Does it work?
Yup.
I'll try it.
Alright. Ooh, there's a funk fever. Come on, get up.
Okay.
There you go.
Ooh, I like this song.
Me too.
Bye. get out now.
I live here.
Not anymore. Not after what you did to my sister. How could you choke her like that? What is the matter with you? What were you thinking?
Did it ever occur to you that maybe I wasn't thinking?
Yeah, you weren't. Now, I want you to tell me what did I tell you on that day you were going to marry my sister. What was it? What was it?
You said that if I were to ever hurt your sister, that you would kill me.
Yes. And I keep my promises, unlike you. You let me down, man. I thought you were the one for her. I never would have thought that you would put your nasty little hands on her. I mean, just because your father dies doesn't mean that it gives you the right to put your hands on my sister. Doesn't mean it gives you the right to become an alcoholic. And it doesn't mean that you have the right to be an a-hole.
Listen, I came here to talk to her, okay? I came here to apologize, and I came here to tell her that I am going to get help for my drinking problem. I'm going to get clean.
You think I care about you going to get clean, huh?
Please, I'm trying to better my life. For my children, for me, for her, because I love them. And I need them, and I know they need me, and that's why I am going to get help. Please. I'm sorry.
You should be. You should be! You have a good wife and good children who love you, who need you. You can't stay sober long enough to take care of them. You make me sick. This is your only chance to make things right. So if you screw this up, there is no other chance. Do you hear me?
Yes.
I said, do you hear me?
Yes, I hear you.
Hey, Dad.
Oh, I'm so glad you're here.
Of course, Dad. How's Mom?
Not so good. The doctors say that your mom needs a liver transplant. And without one in the next 5 hours, she will die. The doctor's afraid if they give her a liver transplant that they won't be able to find the donor for the bone marrow in time, and the liver might be wasted and she'll still die anyway. I really don't know what to do.
Well, Dad, I think the answer's pretty simple. Mom's gonna live. So give her the liver transplant and you know, Mom's gonna live. You're not gonna let her die, are you?
No, of course not. I don't want her to die. I don't want her to go. I don't want a liver being wasted either. If your mom's gonna die, she's gonna die. They can't find a donor for her because she has a rare bone marrow type. And I don't know. Doctors say your mom's chance of survival is pretty close to none.
Dad, you can't say that.
Previously on Bratz Unconditional Love.
I don't want you to die. I need you.
This is not fair, Michael, and you know it. You met my parents.
Destiny, don't do this. I don't want you seeing her like that.
Are you coming here to say goodbye to your children?
I would like to do that if they want. Goodbye. Goodbye.